Okay, so we're now in what's known as Australia Square, which was sort of a more important modern development by one of Sydney's best-known modern architects, Harry Seidler. I guess the most notable thing about it actually was the fact that it created this outdoor plaza area, which allowed for alfresco dining, which really wasn't popular towards the end of the 60s when this development was completed. But these days it's really popular, well, maybe not on Saturdays and Sundays when the building is shut, but during the week it's always full of people having lunch. This little laneway here is known as the Tank Stream Way because originally in this area there was a little freshwater stream which actually provided the fresh water to the early colony. Okay, so we're now standing in what's known as Macquarie Place, yet another thing named after Governor Macquarie. And again, all the landscaping was done by Francis Greenway. But what's most notable here is the cannon and anchor, which we can see behind us here. So both of these items came from the HMS Sirius, which was the flagship of the First Fleet, or basically the warship, the protecting ship. The cannon was unloaded in the first few days of the colony to provide some sort of basic protection for the new settlers. It was never really used, so they painted it over, blocked it up, and put it on display up here. The anchor was actually retrieved from the HMS Sirius when it wrecked off Norfolk Island in 1790. So it wrecked, they sent out another boat a bit later, picked up the anchor, painted it over and put it on display up here. But what it does start to do is start to make us think what the journey out to Sydney might have been like for the convicts on some of these first or second fleets. In actual fact, the second fleet was one of the worst journeys out to Sydney, for the fact that about 1,000 convicts were brought out, but 3 businessmen were given the job of bringing these convicts out to Sydney. So the businessmen were paid for the entire rest of the journey when they loaded all the convicts onto the ships. So during the 6 to 7 months it took them to get out here to Sydney, the businessmen could spend the money on looking after the convicts, making sure they had enough food, they were comfortable, well, all these sorts of things. Or they could spend the money on alcohol, prostitutes, drugs, all these sorts of things. Unfortunately, they headed a lot more towards the drugs, alcohol and prostitutes than they did looking after the convicts. So much so, by the time the Second Fleet arrived here in Sydney, only 750 of the convicts were still alive. And of those, only about 100 of them were described as being in good health. The rest were very sick or even dying at that. So they were generally locked away under the main deck and in an environment that very rarely got dry. And diseases such as scurvy were particularly prevalent. But I guess I'm hoping your journey out to Sydney was a lot better than theirs.
A lot quicker.
And a lot quicker. And we'll continue down along Loftus Street, down towards Circular Quay. So far.
Cool. I spend my time just thinking about you. Every single day, guess I'm really missing you. And all those things we used to do. Hey girl, what's up? It used to be just me and you.
I spend my time just thinking about you. Every single day, guess I'm really missing you. And all those things we used to do. Hey girl, what's up, yo? What's up, what's up, what's up?
Right up the borderline is where I'm going away. For you, I'll be looking out night and day. Took my heart to the limit, and this is where I'll stay. I can't go any further than this. I want you so bad, my only wish.
Girl, I travel around the world and even sail the 7 seas. Across the universe and go to other galaxies. Just tell me where to go, just tell me where you wanna meet. I navigate myself to take me where you be. Cause girl, I want you right now. I travel uptown, I travel downtown. Wanna have you around, like every single day. I love you always, I'll meet you halfway.